Number one. Number two. You have a really big head. We had a little bit of a difficulty there, didn't we, Inca? You're a good girl. It's the second little boy. So we have one more to go. This little fella had a big old head. He's all lovely and dry. And look, he has oven mitt stripes. Good pup. Yeah. Hope you're going to be okay. Their paws are so tiny. Now we have to wait for number three. This is number three. There's a little girl and she came backwards. She came backwards, poor pup. Well, I had to pull her rather rapidly. And luckily she has a smaller head than the two boys. But a louder voice. Listen to you. She has a big white mark on her. You good girl, Inca Dink. Number three just came, but it came backwards. So I had to help Inca and pull it out. Luckily, its head is smaller. There's number two, number three, and here's number one, very dry. So Inca's being a fantastic mother. She's got her lovely nest here. I think that's all. This one is number one, getting in there, out-competing its sister. Let the little sister get some attention. You're such a bully boy. So you can see the size. Fits in my palm of my hand.
So how we tell the three is Inca's ink got darker with each puppy. The first puppy is this pale one. The next puppy is this one that's slightly darker. And the last one is this dark one. This is the female. So you can see they're different grades of darkness. So Inca's ink got progressively darker with each puppy she had. You good girl. You're so good. So this is the little girl. This is a boy. And this is a boy. So puppy one, puppy two, and puppy three. And a good mother. Yes, such a good mother.